Hello everyone. So in this video we are going to do the national parks which are important for CSEs, UPSC CSEs, state PCS, CAPF and other competitive examination. So it will be a series of two or three videos, nearly three videos, in which we will cover all the national parks state wise, starting from the southern states and moving northwards. So in this video you will get the maps and all the important information related to the national parks and their location, which is being asked repeatedly in the competitive examinations. Okay, now let's start. We starting from Tamil Nadu and Kerala. First one is Mukurthi National Park. So let's see in the map. Mukurthi National, you can see here, it is Mukurthi National Park. Okay, it is protected area located in the western corner of the Nilgiri Plateau, west of the Ottukkamund Hills Station, in the northwestern corner of the Tamil Nadu in Western Ghat. Okay, this park, which is here, it is most important. The Nilgiri Thar, this park, Mukurthi National Park, has a keystone species, which was, this park was created to protect this keystone species, Nilgiri Thar. Okay, and it is home to Bengal tiger, Asian elephant. Most of the states in the southern states have this Bengal tiger and Asian elephant. So this is the common in most of the national parks in Kerala, in Tamil Nadu, in Karnataka. You will find this common, and it is a part of Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve. Remember, Mukurthi National Park is a part of Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve. Nilgiri Thar is related to Mukurthi National Park. It is found in Ottukkamund Hill Station and Nilgiri Plateau. No, these are the key terms. These are the key terms which are being used to create MCQs in the competitive examination. So remember these names. Sir, the vegetation present here is a mountain grassland and shrublands. Okay, Mukurthi National Parks, you should remember the location. Sometime they ask in which hills it is located. Okay, then Madhumalai National Park. Madhumalai National Park, it is in Tamil Nadu and shares a boundary with Karnataka and Kerala as well. Here it is Madhumalai National Park, here it is Karnataka and it is Kerala. Okay, it is also a wildlife sanctuary and a tiger reserve. It lies on the northwestern side of the Nilgiri Hills in Tamil Nadu. Have a look. And many protected and vulnerable species can be found here, including Indian elephant, Bengal tiger, gaur and Indian leopard. Indian elephant and Bengal tiger is common, I have told you earlier. Critically endangered white rumped vultures and long billed vultures are also found in Madhumalai National Park. Remember this. Critically endangered Indian white rumped vultures and long billed vultures. Okay. Silent Valley National Parks. It is located in Nilgiri Hills, which within the Palakkad district of the Kerala. So this is the second largest national park of Kerala. It is last undisturbed tracts of southwestern Ghat mountain rainforest and the tropical moist evergreen forest in India. There was a movement, Safe Silent Movement. Remember this name, Safe Silent Movement. It is related to Safe Silent Valley. Okay, this movement was against a proposed hydroelectric project, which the people there assumed that it is going to threaten the rich wildlife of the area of that time. This movement was in 1980. So this movement resulted into the cancellation of this hydroelectric project and the creation of this Silent Valley National Park. Now the valley areas of the park are in tropical and subtropical moist broadleaf forest ecoregion. The ecology becomes very important for the prelims, so you have to learn this anyhow. in this video and the coming video, if you watch this video two or three times, it will somewhat be there, you can't remember everything. So watching this video will refresh your memory, and you should watch this video 1 week before the examination. That is must. Okay, so hilly areas above 1000 meter are in the southwestern Ghats mountain rainforest. BirdLife International lists 16 bird species in Silent Valley as a threatened and restricted. Out of all these, Nilgiri pipit was in news. So always remember, Nilgiri pipit is related to Silent Valley National Park. Okay, here you can see Silent Valley National Park, and the other one is Eravikulam in Periyar. Eravikulam is the oldest national park of Kerala, and Periyar is the largest national park of Kerala. We will study about them also. Eravikulam National Park. Eravikulam National Park is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. So this you have to remember, okay? And it is located along the western Ghats in the Idukki district of the Kerala. Eravikulam National Park, here it is, okay? The main body of the park consists of a high rolling plateau with a base elevation of 2000 meters. The terrain consists of a high altitude grassland interspersed with sholas. You have to learn about shola. What is shola? You have to learn and write in comment of what is shola. Annayamudi. This is the most important point about Eravikulam National Park. Annayamudi is a highest peak south of the Himalayas. So Annayamudi, where it is located, in which national park it is? It is located in Eravikulam National Park. Okay. And many perennial streams crisscross this park. Periyar River and Kaveri. Periyar and its tributaries from the west, and the Kaveri from the east. Lakkom waterfalls. In the examinations like CAPF, SSC, most of the time they mention the name of the waterfalls and ask you which state they are located. So it will be better for you to remember the name of the waterfall, the state in which they are located, and also the area, means the national park or the protected, any of the protected area or the hilly area. If they are, it is a waterfall, it will be located in the hilly area. So you have to remember these names. It will provide you, if you remember these factual points, it will be easier for you to get higher marks in prelims. And Periyar National Park. Periyar, it is notable as an elephant reserve and a tiger reserve. It is the largest national park of Kerala. So this park is a repository of rare, endemic and endangered flora and fauna, and forms the major watershed of the two important rivers of Kerala, Periyar and Pamba. It is easier to remember Periyar since the name of the national park is Periyar itself. For Pamba, if you read it two or three times, it will be very easy for you to remember it. So it is located in Cardamom Hills and Pandalam Hills in the south of the Western Ghats. Here you can see Cardamom Hills. Here it is Annayamudi, which is the highest peak south of the Himalayas, which is the highest peak of the Annayamudi Hills also. Dodda Beta is the highest peak of the Nilgiri Hills. Okay, these are some factual points from me. If a map based question is being asked, then it will be easier for you. You should also know from south which is the southernmost hills, which is and moving northward, and vice versa, means from north to south. Okay, and the prominent peaks in the Periyar National Park is Pachiyarmala, Velimala, Sundarmala, Chakkompetimala and Karimala. These names are a little bit tough, but if you read it 2-3 times, it will become easier for you. The park is made up of the tropical evergreen forest, moist deciduous forest, grassland and eucalyptus, and lake and river system are also found. ecology plays a playing a very big role in the prelims examination. You have to remember this all. There is tropical evergreen forest in Periyar ecosystem. There is a moss deciduous forest. There is a grassland. There is a strands of eucalyptus and lake and river ecosystem is also found there. The forest contains deciduous and semi-evergreen forest. Rosewood, teak, sandalwood, mangoes, jamun, etc. The most important part, the only South Indian conifer, Nagai Velichiana is found in the Periyar National Park. This is the only South Indian conifer. You have to remember this name. Okay. Periyar National Park, the second largest national park of the Kerala. Nagai Velichiana, which is the only South Indian conifer. It is found in the Periyar National Park. Where it is? It is in Cardamom Hills and Pandalam Hills of the Western Ghat. Okay, Tamil Nadu. Now, we move to Karnataka. Bandipur National Park. It was established in 1974 as a tiger reserve under Project Tiger. So, which national park was established under Project Tiger? It was Bandipur National Park. For you, for state PCS examination, the date also become important. So remember this, 1974. It is one of the premier tiger premier tiger reserves in the country, along with the adjoining Nagar Hole National Park. Here you can see, it is Nagar Hole National Park here, and here's Bandipur National Park. Okay. It was once the private hunting reserve for the Maharaja of Kingdom of Mysore, but has now been upgraded as a Bandipur National Park. पहले यहाँ पे बड़ी जाते थे शिकार करने जाया करते थे राजा लोग. So Bandipur is also known for its wildlife and has many types of biomes, but a dry deciduous forest is dominant. So here it is to be noted that there are many biomes in the Bandipur National Parks, but the dominant one is dry deciduous forest. Dry deciduous forest is dominant in most part of the India. Okay, Bandipur National Park is located in Chamarajanagar district. Okay, this name is sorry for the wrong pronunciation, and it is 80 kilometer from the city of Mysore. Then the Ooty, which is the most important tourist destination there. Okay, the most important parts for the Bandipur National Park is that it was established under the Project Tiger, and it is one of the premier tiger reserves in the country. This is the most important point. Okay, the biomes, what are the type of vegetation found there, means there are different types of biomes, but the dry deciduous is dominant there. Remember this only. So the type of fauna found there are teak, rosewood, sandalwoods, Indian laurel, Indian kino, giant clumping bamboo. Read it only through and three times, you will remember this. And Bandipur National Park also suggests good population of endangered and vulnerable species. Indian elephant, gorse, tiger, sloth bears, muggers, Indian rock python, four-horned antelopes, jackals, dholes. The most commonly mammal scenes are cheetah, grey langurs, Indian giant squirrels and elephants. Indian giant squirrel, this is the most important point. Okay, remember, the Indian giant squirrel is found in Bandipur National Park. This is the map for protected areas presented in Karnataka. So it shows the national parks, national highways, sanctuaries also. I tried to find most which will only tell about the national park, but this is the most appropriate map I was able to found. So please consider this only. Now the Kali Tiger Reserve. यहाँ नहीं जाइएगा कभी. क्यों? ये देखिए. यहाँ पे पाए क्या जाता है. Reptiles in the parks include king cobra, spectacle cobra, Russell viper, saw scaled viper, common krait, Indian rock python, rat snake, vine snake, bamboo pit viper, monitor lizard. कभी नहीं जाइएगा यहाँ पे. ठीक है, बस पढ़िए इनके बारे में. It is located in the Uttar Kannada district of Karnataka. The park is a habitat of Bengal tiger, black panther and Indian elephants. So in, again, Indian elephant and Bengal tigers, it is common. And the Kali River, which flows through the tiger reserve, and on this Kali River, the reserve has been named. It is a lifeline for the ecosystem, and hence the reserve was named after this river. The park is in the eco region of the Northwestern Ghats Mountain Rainforest and Northwestern Ghats Moss Deciduous Forest, both of which are deemed as endangered by WWF. Okay, this is important, but you remember this point, okay? The next one is Nagar Hole National Park. You have seen in the map about Nagar Hole, where it is located. See it once again. Nagar Hole National Park, also known as Rajiv Gandhi National Park. This become important. Which park is known as Rajiv Gandhi National Park? Nagar Hole National Park. No, don't get confused. Okay, it is a national park located in the Kodagu district and Mysore district in Karnataka. It is the part of Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve. So you have to remember all the national parks, all the protected areas, which are the part of Nilgiri Biosphere Reserves. Many of the time question is being asked in such a way. Which of the following parks are the part of the Nilgiri Biosphere Reserves? So remember this. We have one of the park earlier done, which was also the part of Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve. The park has a healthy predator-prey ratio, which is not very important. Okay, the vegetation here consists of a Northwestern Ghat Moss Deciduous Forest with the teak and rosewood predominating the southern part. There is a central Deccan Plateau Dry Deciduous Forest and the Pala Indigo and the Thorny Wattle towards the east. There are some sub-mountain valley swamp forest and the several species of Eugenia genus. So this is important, you have to read it. Anything related to vegetation become important for any of the competitive examinations. The most important predators of this Nagar Hole National Park is Bengal tiger and Indian leopard. The herbivore fauna are sambar deer, barking deer, four-horned antelope, gaur, wild boar, Indian elephant. Baner Ghatta National Park. It is popular tourist destination with a zoo, a pet corner, an animal rescue center, a butterfly enclosure, an aquarium, a snake house, a safari park. The park has a hilly terrain of granite sheet and a moist deciduous forest valley and a shrublands on the higher areas. 16 villages border this park. Okay, the park is the part of the wildlife corridor for the elephant, which connects BR Hills and Satyamangalam Forest. This national park, Baner Ghatta National Park, is important, becomes important for examination because of this point only, that this park is a part of the wildlife corridor for elephant, which connects the BR Hills with the Satyamangalam Forest. So remember this point and remember the name of the national park, in which state it is, and the name of the park and the property, which is wildlife corridor for elephant, which connects the BR Hills with the Satyamangalam Forest. This park is contiguous with the Tali Reserve Forest in the southeastern and the Bilical Forest in the south. This is not important, but this point is very important. Okay, the park's rainfall is 700 mm per year. The next one, we move to Telangana. Now it is Kasu Brahmanath Reddy National Park. Kasu Brahmanath Reddy National Park, it is also named Chiran Fort Palace. It was a palace under Nizams. So it was donated by the Nizams to the government for so that it can be developed into a national park. So Kasu Brahmadad Reddy National Park, also known as Chiran Fort Palace, is a national park located in the Jubilee Hills, Hyderabad, Telangana. So points to be remembered are Kasu Brahmanand Reddy National Park is also known as Chiran National Park, located in Jubilee Hills. Okay. And the park provides excellent lung space as in and the environment from the busy city life and the rising pollution levels. So the park has over 600 species of plant life, 140 species of birds and 30 different varieties of butterflies and reptiles. Okay. Pangolin, small Indian civet, peacock, jungle cat. It is famous for peacock. This park is famous for peacock. Kasu Brahmanad Reddy National Park, which is also known as Chiran Fort Palace, is famous for peacock. Then Mahavir Harina Vanasthali National Park. Mahavir was a Jain saint. You must have read it about him in ancient history. Harina means heron. Vanasthali is a name of a place. So Mahavir Harina National Park is a deer national park. Remember the deer, Harina, heron, deer national park located in the Vanasthali Puram. So from this here the Vanasthali came from. Sahib Nagar, Hyderabad. Sahib Nagar is not important. Vanasthalipuram, Hyderabad, Telangana. Park was named after Mahavir, a Jain saint, in commemoration of 2500 Nirvana anniversary in 1975. This was created in 1975. It is also known as Deer National Park. And Deer National Park is also known as Mahavir Harina Vanasthali National Park. Remember all this. So, if a question is asked, which of the park is related to both Jain and Nizams, it is Mahavir National Park. Okay. So, animals living in the national parks, a few hundred of black bucks, Salman Khan. Okay. A state animal of black bucks are the state animal of Andhra Pradesh. Kabhi Andhra Pradesh na jaye Salman Khan, acha unke liye. To aur porcupines, water monitor, short toed eagles, and Indian pond herons and egrets, kingfishers, bhag gaya jo, aur aise isi tarah ke naam yaad rakhiyega. Panther, black bucks, cheetal deer, wild boar, civet, porcupine, peacock, are the fauna founder, and the flora present here are a mix of shrub and mixed with shrub jungle and grasslands, sandalwood, rosewood, palas, and teak, etc. Last one is Nehru Zoological Park. Nehru Zoological Park is also known as Hyderabad Zoo or Zoo Park. It is a zoo located near Mir Alam Tank in Hyderabad, Telangana. Nearly 100 species of birds, animals and reptiles are housed in this zoo, including the indigenous animals like Indian rhino, Asiatic elephant, Asiatic lion, Bengal tiger, panther, gaur, Indian elephant and slender lion, python, as well as deer, antelope and birds. So we have completed the national parks of the South India. Now we will move northward and we will cover rest of the India, and in the last video we will cover about the hilly the national parks is present in the hilly area, which include northeastern part and the Jammu and Kashmir and the Uttarakhand and Himachal Pradesh. So since the questions become very important, become very complex when it comes to the hilly areas of northeastern and the parks related to Jammu, Kashmir and Uttarakhand. So best of luck for examinations. Watch this video 2 or 3 times before examinations, and just 1 week or 2 or 3 days before the examination, watch this video only once. It will remember, you will be able to remember the in the examination. If a name pop up which is similar to the those which you have read in this lesson. Okay, thank you, bye bye.